Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Check It Out, the library talk show that lets you know what's going on in and around the Bethel Park Public Library. We're your hosts, Elaine Volpe.
And Christine McIntosh.
And we want to wish everybody a happy winter, because winter is already on its way.
Yes.
So it's hard to believe, and we thank you for a successful fall. I know we had high attendance at our programs, and I think the adult side did as well.
Yes, we did as well.
As we enter winter, we have some more fun things to tell you about. So over to you, Christine.
So with the adult programs, we have a couple special programs coming up. The first one will be on Tuesday, November 7th at 7 p.m., and it is Make Your Kitchen Work for You. This is Jill Yesko. She's a professional organizer. She'll be at the library to help you plan your kitchen space for maximum productivity and how to like set up zones for baking and preparation and cooking, to establish a small command center for busy moms and dads. So this course will help you see your kitchen in a whole new way, and will be great for holiday cooking. So.
Absolutely. I wish you could come to my kitchen and help me organize.
She actually can do that.
Really?
She does do individual. She'll come to your house and help you organize whatever it is that you want to organize. Again, that's Tuesday, November 7th at 7 o'clock. On Monday, November 19th at 7 o'clock, it's our monthly genealogy group meeting. Actually, I was just talking to Rob, and genealogy group might have to go on hiatus. The man and woman, it's a couple that host the group, they may be bowing, it may be time for them to bow out.
Oh,
so
no.
If you have knowledge and interest in genealogy, we will be looking for a new group leader. In the meantime, you can come to the genealogy group Monday, November 19th at 7 o'clock. And also, too, this is one of my favorites, Monday, November 25th at 7 p.m., we have gift wrapping with Jackie Williams.
Yes.
Jackie is one of our staff members. She works in the Youth Services Department. And I teased her when she was coming back to the library. She had been away from us for a little while. I guess she sobbed, but I had teased her that I would only hire her back if she would teach her gift wrapping class. So,
she's been practicing upstairs. She's been wrapping some boxes, and I had to tell you, they look great. Just really creative ways, different ways.
With stuff you probably have around your house.
Yes.
That's what I liked about it.
Save money on wrapping paper this season.
So Jackie will demonstrate unique and creative ways to wrap your gifts for the upcoming holiday season. Again, that's Monday, November 25th at 7 p.m., and then just some of our clubs that meet regularly at the library. Tuesdays at 1 o'clock is our Scrabble club. And that's just fun, friendly games of Scrabble. Nobody's throwing tiles or getting upset. We provide the game. We do provide dictionaries and a space. So it's informal, but it's a lot of fun. Once in a while, I've sat in. Not for quite some time, but that's Tuesdays at 1. Wednesday evenings from 6:30 to 8:30 p.m. is the Very Rowdy Knitters Group. They're a great group of people, men and women, and they come in, they bring their yarn, their patterns, and their needles, and they stitch, and they talk, and they learn. They're very helpful to newcomers. One of our staff members, Jimmy, he knits, and when he did not know how to do a certain stitch, he went in to see the ladies, and they helped him. So if you're interested in knitting, come to the group on Wednesday evenings. And also, we have Pinochle Club that meets at the library on the second and fourth Friday of the month. So you can come join fellow Pinochle players. This is not a class. They're not there to teach you. This is more of a social time to get together, talk, and play Pinochle. So if you have an interest and know how to play, please join them. Fundraising. I just want to talk a little bit about fundraising. I want to thank all of our vendors and the shoppers that came to our annual vendor fair on Saturday, October 26th. We had 19 vendors and a lot of shoppers, and I want to thank each vendor that they each donated a Chinese auction item for us to raffle off, and we did raise some funds with that. So thank you again. What we have for fundraising currently is the library is selling entertainment books, those big, thick, beautiful books of coupons for that go from car rentals to hotels to restaurants, clothing stores.
Museums are in there.
Museums. There's a lot of local attractions in there. So we are selling those for $25 each, and the library gets a portion of the proceeds. A new thing that we've not done before is we're having an Avon fundraiser during the month of November. It'll be through November 26th. It's not all of the Avon products. It's the lotions, body sprays, and body wash, and sometimes powder. They're in four-piece packs, and each four-piece pack sells for $10. The products will be delivered to the library around the end of the first week of December. So you can come pick those up, and the library will receive 40% of the sales. So I encourage you. I'll be having staff with their envelopes too, and board members. So I'm sure you'll hear it from somebody. And we also are now selling library themed t-shirts. We have three designs. One is, it's symbols. It says a pen greater than sword. So pen is mightier than the sword. We have in Libris Libertas, which is in books there is freedom, and then also Atticus Finch. And I was asked by some of the staff members, why Atticus Finch? And I said, Atticus Finch is a great role model.
So it's both of our favorites.
Yeah,
I love
so
Atticus
Finch. That's why we have Atticus Finch. The shirts are available in black or white t-shirts with bright green graphics lettering on it. They're available in medium, large, and extra large, and they are $15 each. You can order them on our website or through our website, or also at the library itself. So, and we will ship continentally for an additional $3.
And the pictures of the t-shirts are on the website.
The pictures
so
of
if you're
the,
curious.
Yeah, there is an order page on the website. It shows the t-shirts, each t-shirt, and then there's a drop-down menu so you can choose the size and color. And we also have the Winter Lottery Raffle. This is our second year doing this. The Winter Lottery Raffle, we have 1,000 tickets. It's based on the Pennsylvania Daily three-digit drawing at 7 o'clock. So you get a number. It's $5 to get a ticket. Get you a three-digit number. That number is good all month. The daily, like Monday through Friday, we pay $25. Maybe it's Monday through Saturday. Monday through Saturday is $25. Sunday, if your number is drawn, it's $50. And then on Christmas, we have a $500 pot for that day. So if your number is drawn on December 25th, you get a larger prize. So hopefully you'll see us down at South Park Shops on Saturdays in December selling the tickets. And they're also available through the library, and also some staff members and board members have the tickets. So if you see us out and about in the community, you can ask us for a ticket. And also, fall is a time where a lot of students are taking the SATs, the PSATs, the ACTs, as well as some college students are taking some professional tests, the Praxis or the nursing test. And we do have a resource available for you for free through our website. It's called the Testing and Education Resource Center. It is a database that has full-length practice tests that you can take, which are scored, and they also give you explanations if you get an answer wrong. They give you an explanation as to why it was wrong. They help you study what you should study, you know. So we're going to show you now a short video tutorial of how that works exactly, and then you can use it on your own at home. So we'll be right back.
From here, we see an outline of where all the test preparations begin. There's a high school level, college prep level, career tools, and then there's also grad school and international located at the top. Here at the bottom, you can also see a U.S. citizenship test. Under the high school tab, you see a number of different preparation tests. There's the GED, the AP exam, ASVAB, and several others. Under the college, there's CLEP, and then also the SAT and the ACT or the PSAT. Under the career, there's ASVAB, the proxy, and then you can research careers, online resume builder. There's several things you can do here. Under the grad school, you can look at GRE, GMAT, and then you can do a graduate school search, look through all the different graduate schools that are available. And for international, there's TOEFL, and the U.S. citizenship, as I mentioned earlier. On the homepage, as you can see, under the college, there's also ways to find and pay for college, or a resume that you can build for a college application, which is also listed underneath the high school tools. When going into an exam, let's look at the AP exam. There's online practice tests here for biology, calculus, chemistry, English, etc. There's also online books you can use, other resources, articles, and then related links. Let's look at a practice test to begin. Under the biology, it says find out what you need to study before you take the real thing. The AP biology exam covers topics such as molecules, cells, genetics, evolution, organisms, population, and ecology. What you can do here is you can take 2-time full-length tests. You can find detailed answers and explanations for every question. You can also use what you learn to target your study time. If you click Start Now, it takes you to a login page. From this login page, if you just want to register, you can do that. But that is the only way you can take a practice test or go through it to any other part of this database. If you have a generic search, you're looking for a certain type of test, go ahead into the right-hand top corner. There's a search box. Go ahead and type in the term that you're looking for.
Welcome back. That's what's going on in the adult department. Now we'll turn it over to Elaine, and you can tell us what's going on in youth services.
Okay. Well, I just want to thank everybody again, like I said, for a successful and happy fall. We had a good time at all of our clubs and activities. And those most popular clubs we are going to keep, and you'll see them again next year. But of course, we're throwing in some new ones for 2014 as well. So that's on the horizon. Upcoming events this month, I want to let everybody know about our holiday tradition, the annual gingerbread workshop. Always a good time. And this is being held on Saturday, December 7th, between the hours of 12 and 4 p.m. So we'll provide the iced tea cartons for you and the graham crackers. But we do ask that each family bring a can of icing or a bag of candy, or both, to share. So you walk away with a cute little gingerbread house. And this year, we're going to see if any families want to keep theirs on display here at the library.
That would be
but
nice.
Just a great way to get into the holiday spirit. It's a tradition that we've been doing for quite a while and that
yes.
We're always happy to continue for you. We're also having a holiday open house in December. Well, that too was in December. December 14th from 1 to 3 p.m. You can stop by for some hot chocolate and cookies and ornament making. And also, hopefully, you'll want to stay for our drama club's holiday performance. They are going to be performing Granny Goodman, which should sound familiar to you, Christine.
Granny
I
Goodman.
I believe you were Granny just a few years back.
I wasn't Granny Goodman. Mary Mullen was Granny Goodman.
That's right, Mary was Granny.
I was one of the supporting cast members.
We were an excellent housewife.
I was a housewife. It was a stretch.
So it's a cute little play that we performed as a staff a few years ago, and now we're having the kids perform it in the library drama club. So Miss Jackie is heading that up, and I'm looking forward to their performance in December. Okay, so those were both December. I guess I should talk about November. Our programs and our clubs have ceased. Most of them are dying down or are already over. But we have the Step Together workshop, which is particularly for families with young children. The workshop really focuses on kids birth through 3 years old, but really up until 5 years old they can come to. And the Step Together workshop is a family gathering, really, where we take out all of our family place materials. So all of our toys and instruments and special books and whatnot come out into the room for an open play time. It's free play for the kids, but it's really great for the parents too because they get to mingle with one another. One of our moms group came forth about from this. So it's really great, you know, just to talk to other moms and get advice and maybe start some play groups and types of things. And dads too, of course. But it's also a great time to ask questions to our resource professional. At each workshop, we make an effort to have one community professional be present there and answer any questions that parents may have. So we focus on a different topic every week. The first one is literacy, so I will be the professional on hand. Lynn Hahn, too, is an expert. Any one of us can answer questions about when should your child really be picking up a book? When does he or she start turning the pages? When should you start reading to your child? And, of course, the answer is it's never too early. You can even begin reading to them in the womb. It's so very important. So we'll be talking about books, and we're always happy to recommend good books for you. That's week one. Week two is speech development. So we have a speech pathologist who is going to be here to answer any questions that you might have about your son or daughter's language development. You know, if they're not talking by three, should you be concerned? If they're not talking by two, I know some parents have concerns.
Yes.
So the expert will be there to let you know when you really should start addressing those concerns. Week three is child development. So we have Lou Ann Canole joining us. She was a child development teacher here in the Bethel Park School District for, I want to say, over 30 years.
Wow.
35 years. So she's always willing to come back, and we appreciate that. Week four is nutrition and health. And so we'll have hopefully the same gal from the Market District, Giant Eagle. She was great last time. She gave, you know, it's ways to sneak those veggies in there and those fruits without the kids knowing. Always has some yummy new snack ideas for us. And then we finished the workshop with the focus on music. And we usually do like a sample music class, whether it be Kinder Music or Music Together. We have a couple different contacts, but we will get somebody here to teach a music class for us because a lot of people don't realize how crucial music is to a child's development.
It's very good for brain development.
Absolutely. Yes. So those are the five topics, and we really encourage you to sign up. It will start Wednesdays in November, I believe, so the calendar's not in front of me. I want to say it's November 6th. It'll go, because it's 5 weeks, it'll go into that first Wednesday in December. And the workshop's at 10 a.m.
Wonderful.
So that's for the little ones. I do want to talk about my favorite program of all that
is
upcoming.
Children's Choice Awards.
How did you know?
I know.
The Children's Choice Awards, or CCA for short. Now, this is for older kids. We're focusing on grades 4, 5, and 6. And just this past week, we started going into the schools to talk to these classes and to get the kids hyped up. This is the flyer that's been going to the schools. We'll have a couple extras at the desk if you're interested, and this will also be on our website. But Children's Choice Awards, I know we've talked about it on the show before, is an initiative that we do in conjunction with the Allegheny Intermediate Unit, and it started a few years back, and basically it's teachers and librarians in the county choose the best books published in a year. So Children's Choice Awards 2014 will be voting on books that were published in 2013. Now, as you know, Christine, there's hundreds, probably thousands of books that are published in any given year.
Thousands.
So it's
tens
really,
of thousands.
Yeah, so it's really hard to dwindle that list down, but there is a committee, and we send an email out across the county, again, so anybody can vote. Any teacher, public librarian, school librarian can have a say. And after all the input, all the suggestions and recommendations are in, the committee then narrows that list down to about 50, and then we narrow it down to about 25. Then we narrow it down to eight books that we know are gonna have a huge kid appeal, and ones that we know are quality books that are really well written. And from those eight books, we ask the kids to read them and to vote, so it's kids' pick. So it's similar to a Mock Newbery. Everybody's heard of the Newbery or the Caldecott Award. But the difference here is we're having the kids pick. We think if it's a children's book, then the children should be reading it and voting. So we encourage any 4th, 5th, or 6th grader to read these 8 books, come to some of the meetings. The requirement is 2. We'll have 5 book club meetings here at the library. Get together, talk about the book, do an activity. If you come to at least 2 of those, you are automatically invited to the red carpet event in May. And it's my favorite just because
it's exciting.
It's exciting.
We really
fun.
Have
it's
a red carpet. And there's paparazzi there. And
it's aired here on BPTV. And last year we had State Representative Matt Smith join us. I mean, it really is a big deal. And it's just so important for the kids to realize, I think, you know, their opinion does matter.
Yes, it does.
And these books are great. You read them and you let us know what you think.
It's very exciting for the kids because that during the red carpet event, it is announced, and it's not just our kids, our Bethel kids.
And we're very careful not to leak anything out before. The winner is not
very
announced
secretive.
Until the red carpet event.
I never know until it's announced there.
Yeah.
But it's not only the Bethel kids vote, it's countywide. So it's becoming more and more popular. It's always been a big deal to us here in Bethel, but it is becoming bigger in the county. More and more libraries are participating, and now it has state exposure. Elaine just presented a session at the annual Pennsylvania Library Association conference last week on the Children's Choice Awards, hoping for it to gain popularity statewide.
You know, I wasn't even nervous. You know how I am talking in front of people. I've gotten comfortable in the camera. I wasn't even nervous because it was
it's
so
easy.
You
love.
Right, and I was so excited about it, and so excited that other people were curious about it, and you know, wanting to not copy our program, but you know, take our ideas and run with it. That it was just very exciting for me. It was very laid back. So yeah, it is picking up like crazy. But it's always been something that we like to focus on here in Bethel. I wanted to announce the 8 books. Those have been released, so I can officially announce them. They are True Blue Scouts of Sugar Man Swamp by Kathy Apelt, Doll Bones by Holly Black, Flora and Ulysses by Kate DiCamillo, Fortunately the Milk by Neil Gaiman, Escape from Mr. Limoncello's Library by Chris Gravenstein.
My favorite.
Tangle of Knots by Lisa Graff, Pie in the Sky by Wendy Mass, and Rump by Liesl Shurtleff. She's a new author. This is her debut book. So again, just fantastic list of books. I already have my prediction, but I'm not going to let that out just yet. But and we're also very excited. We always have some sort of entertainment at the red carpet event. This year, we are super excited to have an author, John Oxier, who was the author of, or is the author of, Peter Nimble and His Fantastic Eyes. Now, he's not on the list, but that's because that book was published in 2012. So you see it's not eligible. But he does have an author, or a new book coming out, a new book coming out in May, which is perfect timing.
Oh, perfect timing.
And then maybe it will be a contender for next year's CCA. But we got to meet him at this PLA conference, and he's just a great guy, very down to earth and very fun. So he is our guest speaker for CCA this year.
That'll be wonderful.
So we're going into the schools, like I said, and this flyer should be coming home with fourth, fifth, and sixth graders. But if you have any questions, please feel free to call, stop in. We're requesting the books, so they will be available for checkout any day.
What do you got going on for teens? Anything? So
teens, thank you for reminding me. Teens, well, you know what movie's coming out in just a few short weeks. I put this on my Facebook page yesterday because I'm so pumped about it. Hunger Games, the second one. Mm-hmm. Catching Fire is being released on Friday, November 22nd at midnight. Now, because it's a school night, we're not going to do anything for that. But Friday at 7 p.m., we're going to have our Catching Fire program. It'll start at 6 o'clock, and I did it a little bit earlier so that we can all then, if we want to, go over to the movie and watch it together. So we can't, you know, you all need to find your own transportation, but I plan on going straight to the movie. I know a couple other staff members do, and so we can head over, whether it's at the Village or the Galleria, we can plan on going and watching the movie together. We'll probably want to get our tickets in advance, but you can call the library and we'll figure that out and we'll give you more details. But we're going to hold a little pre-party, if you will, to get excited about it on Friday, November 22nd at 6 p.m. And then in December, we're doing a homemade Christmas. So if you're feeling crafty, you can come and join us to make some homemade gifts, because I know, you know, a lot of teens want to buy things for their family, but if you don't have a job yet, you know, it's sometimes difficult. If you don't get an allowance, what can you give them? Well, homemade gifts, I think, are always the best anyway. So we're gonna have a couple gifts for you to make. You'll make some homemade cards, and of course, because Miss Jackie's helping out with this program, you'll also make the homemade wrapping paper. So you'll go with a gift already wrapped and ready to go to one of your loved ones. So that's what we have going on for teens. I did mention that the new flyer will be ready. It looks like this. These will be up on the website next week and available at the children's desk. This is the birth through preschool flyer. Our grade school flyer looks something like this. Clubs on the front and the back. Check out those new clubs that are coming up. And then our teen flyer looks something like this. A lot of cool programs for teens. We're going to do a murder mystery for the first time this spring.
Fun.
A murder mystery dinner. We've done murder mysteries before, but we're going to include dinner this time. So a lot of fun things on the horizon. You can check those out. And again, always call if you have any questions.
Well, we will take a look at our past program highlight now, which is our annual Haunted Hat Tea, which is a lot of fun. Mm-hmm. This was in October, and we award prizes for the kookiest hat. So you'll see a past program highlight, and I just want to remind everybody, too, that we will be doing our annual holiday tea party on Friday, December 13th. So if you're interested in that, it is $5 to cover the cost of the refreshments, but you can sign up at the library. So enjoy the past program highlight. Okay, so today we are at our annual Haunted Hat Tea. This is our third year, I believe, doing the Haunted Hat Tea. It's a fun time for people to come together, talk with their friends, and enjoy some tea. And today we have finger sandwiches. They're shaped like fingers, and they are stuffed with ham salad or chicken salad. So we're looking forward to the reaction to that. And we have a contest every year during our Haunted Hat Tea. The person that has the kookiest Halloween-themed hat will win a prize. Today we're also going to be playing Halloween bingo. We have some Halloween jokes and trivia, and we will be giving away some prizes. So hope you enjoy it.
This is Barb, and she's going to talk about two hats today. So tell me about the hat you're wearing first, Barb.
The hat I'm wearing has to do with the great pumpkin, the Charlie Brown special. That was always a favorite of mine. So it's the great pumpkin, and it's the pumpkin patch. And I think Charlie Brown is there, yes.
Very, very adorable. And this is a Pittsburgh hat, and it was worn by someone shy that didn't want to be on TV. But Barb's going to tell us about it.
My sister Pat, and she's an artist, so I thought this was really clever. She ties in, this is Stephen Foster, this is Andrew Carnegie, so everyone has to do with the city of Pittsburgh. This is the Steeler zombie, and she's got these various other owls, and her name is Patty, so I call it the Batty Patty. I told her, this is clever. So she has bats all over the place, and she has skeletons playing music. I guess this would represent the symphony. And the duck. So the duck, of course, would have to be here, because that's so much a part of Pittsburgh. And it's scary good, of course. Oh, and then this Pittsburgh Steeler is holding a little orange cup that says Halloween tea.
In honor of our Halloween tea.
Right, because even though we have these Steelers, they're not so macho that they wouldn't have tea.
That
right?
They could drink tea with us, exactly. Well, thank you, Barb.
Hope to see you next year at our annual Haunted Hat Tea. Well, thank you for tuning in. If you'd like more information on any of the programs and services we talked about, you can always give us a call.
Click on our website.
Or better yet, come on in.
Thanks, everybody. And we're leaving you tonight with some of the book trailers from the CCA nominees. So enjoy.